Hi fellows and welcome to this video! Today we'll go through the newest features of Odyssey 2.1 that was released in October 14th, 2024. Animation cells now go thumbnails, which should help a lot in the creative process. In addition, the pre and post behaviors now displays icons. If Odyssey 2 introduced the image marks to assign a visual tag to your animation cells, Odyssey 2.1 also offers a system to easily scrub between specific frames within specific limits using the combination of a keyboard shortcut and a movement of the hand with your stylus or mouse. The configuration can be done in the editor preferences, and if you're lost among the possibilities, everything is explained in details in the user guide that got updated. Version 2 introduced the concept of widgets to create a level sequence with an animation asset. This widget got improved and can now create an empty animation asset with the level sequence. Additionally, media textures will now be displayed in the text list when working on 3D meshes. Raster selection used to be faulty and could often lead to crashes. This should no longer be the case, which will enhance your workflow, especially when storyboarding. Additionally, you will find a contextual menu to clear the selection, revert it, copy, cut, and paste. There are two small improvements available in Raster Transform. First, it will automatically select the entire canvas if no selection was done beforehand. And two, it can flip horizontally and vertically. Note, by the way, that you can also flip the whole canvas thanks to these two icons at the bottom. Vector palette interface got improved to display a save icon and add two buttons to add colors, add folders, and duplicate asset. As you know, board and shot sequences to create storyboards have limited tracks compared to level sequences. So, you'll find now an option when right-clicking on a board sequence to turn it into a hierarchy of level sequences. Additionally, this feature enables the possibility to render an XML file with a video for each shot instead of one single video file for the entire storyboard. Additional tiny changes were done, such as no more camera key by default to prevent the creation of unwanted camera moves, and if you want to create a camera move, you will have to click here. Camera shakes options are back. You can toggle off all light tables. And cloning a drawing that has just been created will no longer suffer from refresh issues, which make it very nice to use, especially when working with vector layers. And that's a wrap for Odyssey 2.1. However, you may ask, what's about FAB and its compatibility with Odyssey? Unless you're living under a rock, you know the Unreal Engine Marketplace was replaced by FAB. And good news everyone, it does not change anything for Odyssey. Go to FAB, buy or get the assets you like, and add them to your vault in the Epic Games Store. From there, nothing else has changed and you will find the next steps to add content to your Odyssey project thanks to the guide or thanks to this video tutorial. There are many new things to expect in the near future, like automatic in-betweens for the vector animation layers and the 2D timeline being integrated into the sequencer. Support Odyssey development by ordering now a license from our website. You can also like, comment, and share this video to spread the good word. Thank you all, take care, and see you soon. Bye!